my joke is I'm from Alabama, but I'm really from Nairobi, Kenya. I was born in Tanzania and raised in Africa my whole life. And one of my passions is not the Africa good the same way as the West. There's such a cross-pollination that can be done between Africa and the West, where we can actually learn from each other and come into balance as a whole. I'm having a rockability concert, and that's rock for sustainability in Nairobi, Kenya. We're hoping to get Jay-Z along for that. We already have Matt Sorum of Guns N' Roses, Stevie Salas, we have T.M. Stevens, who's jammed with Tina Turner, and we have Bernard Fowler, who's been the backing vocalist for Rolling Stones. They're all coming to Kenya to do a rock safari for sustainability, which will move us into a sustainable economy. The plan is to make Kenya the most sustainable economy in Africa as a pioneering example and a blueprint. And with the funds, we've got a three-tier structure for the funds that we raise. The first one is sustainable training seminars. The winner of that seminar will be mentored towards success, taught how to raise funding, and also taught how to form teams and bring their business to market as a pioneering example to the rest of Kenya. The second level is to build a sustainable community that is sustainable in water, electricity, food, and all the rest of it in a chic way. And so that's the second level, and that will become a pioneering example for the rest of Kenya. The third level is a research and training centre where we actually unite people for sustainable business, sustainable communities, and sustainable lives, so that we can all walk together through the same system instead of a system and an economy that doesn't necessarily work for everyone. What works here doesn't necessarily work in Africa. Africa is also very powerful and unique. It seems to be a poor continent that's exploited for publicity. And really, Africa is massive. China, Argentina, and America all fit into Africa. So we're rebranding Africa as a powerful new place with dynamic opportunities for investors and for people that want to come and learn from Africa as opposed to coming to us to teach. Ed is amazing. I met him just now. He heard about my project, gave me lots of empowering thoughts on that, told me a little bit about him. He's beautifully modest. I think the biggest thing I learned about Ed is that he said, I came from the street and I treat everyone the same. And that is huge, and that's such an important message to everyone. It's not about where you come from, it's not about who you are. It's really about what you do with this life and what you do with the power of the moment.